wild animals tested each year, it is estimated that over 150 million animals are tested on each year. These are some major milestones in the history of animal testing. Animal testing was believed to have first been performed by Almosian, a Greek philosopher, in 450 BC. After over 100 people were killed by a deadly elixir in 1937, it prompted the Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act of 1938. This law essentially mandated animal testing. Starting in 1993, the EU launched a program to phase out animal testing for cosmetics and their ingredients, which resulted in a complete ban on animal-tested cosmetics in 2013. In 2016, the Netherlands launched an ambitious plan to phase out animal testing for biomedical research by 2025. This plan was widely criticized as unattainable, but it still shows a potential solution. Should animal testing be used for biomedical research? I say no, because animal testing for biomedical research should be discontinued due to the ethical and economic concerns associated with it. I will be looking into this through the ethical and economic lenses. What are we doing?
It'll show. It's go back and go back.
It's just that. Greater than 50% of approved drugs were removed from the market due to safety concerns in the US and Canada. When this many drugs are removed from the market, it means that there is something wrong with the system. It also leads to companies and investors that invest millions of dollars into these drugs, they lose all of that money. If different testing measures were put into place that could give earlier indications of the negative safety effects, then companies could save large amounts of money by not having to continue to test unsafe products. The history of cancer research has been a history of curing cancer in the mouse. We have cured mice of cancer for decades, and it simply doesn't work in humans. We need to acknowledge the fact that the use of animals will not make us better scientists, but bitter scientists. This quote comes from Richard Klausner, former director of the U.S. National Cancer Institute. He acknowledges that even after decades of research in which mice have been cured of cancer, those same cures don't work on humans. This equates to millions of lost dollars that could have been used to fund other cancer treatments on alternatives or humans that could be more effective. Next, I will be looking through the ethical lens. Their bodies are burned, mutilated, and scarred. Animals who have had their heads crushed, ripped their faces and convulsed as blood pours out of the noses. You can smell and taste the stench of blood, feces, and fear. This quote comes from Asha Akhtar, a neurologist based on her observations entering a facility that uses animal testing. She acutely describes the horrors that she witnessed. These are not a one-time occurrence. These things are the reality of what is happening to thousands of animals around the world currently. Stories like this have found their way into the American public and have resulted in 52% of Americans opposing scientific animal testing. In addition to negatively impacting humans, animal testing also negatively impacts humans. If a substantial amount of Americans are dying and being hospitalized due to drug reactions, that means that there is something wrong with the current testing methods. These current methods mainly rely on animal testing. It is simply unethical to let these drugs continue to kill and injure humans. And as you can see here, they killed 125,000 people in the US each year and hospitalized 2.7 million people. Conclusion. Animal testing is unethical, uneconomic, and unsafe. Animal testing is unethical due to the harm that it places on animals as well as humans. Animal testing is uneconomic due to its ineffectiveness, which means millions of dollars spent on drugs are wasted. Animal testing is unsafe due to the dangers that it poses to humans because of its inability to accurately test drugs. In order to eliminate animal testing, we together and come up with a solution to animal testing. This solution needs to have specific, attainable dates. The European Union's phasing out of cosmetic testing, as well as the Netherlands' goal to phase out animal testing for biomedical purposes, can be used as examples to come up with this solution. This plan will most likely include relocating government spending from animal testing procedures into funding for developing alternative methods. The next step would likely be to incentivize businesses into using these alternative methods. After this, they will likely ban vertebrates and testing of vertebrates, and researchers would have to use invertebrates such as placozoans or sponges. Next, the government would not allow finished drugs to be tested on animals, only their ingredients. The final step would be a complete ban on animal testing. This process will likely take a long time, and it will likely be difficult, but overall, the pros will far outweigh the cons.
Thank you. Round of applause. Claudia, how did your research question evolve as you moved through the process? And did your research go in any different directions than you originally planned?
Yes, it did. So when I was first starting to research this, my original opinion was yes, but I was going to say that you should still experiment on animals. But as I dug in deeper, and instead of just looking at how it benefits humans, I looked more into the economic standpoint, and I saw how it's been losing millions of dollars and how that's negatively impacting.
Another question. If you had more time, what additional research would you conduct related to this issue?
I think I would look a little bit deeper into the history, because I only had a chance to look at some of the major things that have gone on in history. But if I could look into something more, I would look more into the history of it, so I can see deeper what has happened and what that shows for what will happen in the future.
Okay, thank you.